So, what movie do you guys want to watch tonight?
Wreck-It Ralph?
The Lego Movie?
Inside Out?
Nah. I've seen those really good movies before. Let's try something different.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to go browse through on demand, see what we got. Okay, got you Detroit, like a Ninjago movie. Never seen that. Despicable Me 3, meh. Wind Driver, Cars 3, meh. Ooh, what's this movie?
The Emoji Movie?
The Emoji Movie.
Sounds good.
Yeah. I don't know, guys. This might be dangerous.
But look at it. It looks like a beautiful family-friendly movie. What are you talking about?
Looks pretty family-friendly.
Look at this. Look at that. 9%. That means 9 out of 10, right?
Yeah. It's like a 90. Yeah. It's like an A-.
Yeah. I hope this isn't a mistake.
Okay.
Me too.
Time to rent it.
The Emoji Movie.
How do I get these stupid emojis off my keyboard? Let's screw this.
This movie was not something to smile about.
It was horrendous.
Yeah, it was really bad.
Absolutely awful.
Yeah, okay. We're gonna expose this movie now with the 6 factors. Let's just say that the Emoji Movie was horrendous. It's just, I'll tell you why it's bad. You already know it's bad, but I'll tell you why.
First, we got the cliche.
The bad jokes.
The propaganda.
The character flaws.
The cringe factor.
And the plot holes.
Before we get into all of that, I'm going to explain the background of the movie so you're a little more familiar with what we're going to talk about.
So this movie is about a meh emoji named Gene. But the only problem is he doesn't know how to make a meh face, and he makes multiple emotions instead. And when it's his turn to be texted, he makes the wrong face and destroys the entire text place. I don't know what it's called. So, the antagonist, Smiler, who's the leader of all the emojis, sends evil and really idiotic bots after him. When he's being chased by bots, he meets High Five, and him and High Five try to find a hacker, but they do not know the way to find one. So, they find the hacker, and she tells them that they need to find a source code so they can fit in with the other emojis.
Before we get into the points, I'm going to tell you the surface level of the movie. What you might see with the commercial or the first glance at the movie without looking through the lines, without paying attention too hard. That it's supposed to be hip, new, the new Lego movie, the new Wreck-It Ralph movie, 2017, trendy for preteens. It's supposed to be a fun, creative movie. But the problem was that they paid too much attention on having advertisements inside of the movie that they did not pay attention to the things that the movie needed for a concrete level, such as character flaws. They didn't take enough time on characters, such as cliche moments. They didn't realize that they were not original. They had a lot of things like plot holes and all of these that happened because of them trying to put in propaganda. But it was supposed to be trendy, but since the propaganda thing, it collapsed a thing and it is not trendy because they tried to force it too much because they didn't.
This movie had many pointless scenes and plot holes throughout the entire film that they never really cared to fix or resolve. For example, Mary Meh, Jean's mother, constantly says that she feels different emotions. And she's never cast out like Jean is. Even though Jean feels different emotions, it doesn't make any sense. Also, when the phone is wiped, which is the like world-ending event for all the emojis are not wiped. They are kept on the phone because they're standard to everybody. So technically, the Emoji Movie is happening on every single phone in the world. Also, during the movie, Jailbreak claims that all emojis are either princesses or brides. This is clearly false, as Smiler is female. I just believe that the movie was looking for a reason to make Jailbreak mad at everybody.
In this movie, there aren't many characters that I need to keep track of. We've already talked about Gene, Jailbreak, High Five, Smiler, the antagonist, and her really stupid bots. But there are some characters in this movie that make me want to punch a hole in a wall. First of all, I want to talk about Gene's parents. Throughout the entire movie, they talk like this.
I'm so nervous, I could almost shrug. Don't overreact. I told you not to overreact.
Right now, I'm so overwhelmed with passionate feelings for you.
And it's just so boring and annoying because they're going through marriage struggles. That's a really big deal. And through the entire thing, they're like, oh, I don't love you anymore. And it's just, whenever a scene shows up with Gene's parents, I just slouch back on the couch and was like, why was this in the movie? What am I watching right now? They're just the most two-dimensional characters I've ever seen in an entire movie. Okay, now that's out of the way. We have Alex, who is their user. Their user! He controls what the emojis do! He is literally the person who taps on the emoji, where they get scanned and they get sent a text message to somebody else. But Alex, listen to me. Alex is so boring. He has literally no point. Like, they tried to represent what a teenage boy acts and does, like what he does. And he only has around seven lines for the entire movie. And wanna know what those lines are? Oh, Addy, wanna go to the dance with me? Or, I'm gonna send an emoji, which one should I send? Okay, that's all I need to say about character flaws.
The Emoji Movie had to have the word movie, just to make us remember that it is a movie. Because literally the plot is just advertisements. What happens is Gene, High Five, and Jailbreak go through apps, which are real. Such as they have a game tutorial of Candy Crush. They play Candy Crush, and they go play and Just Dance. And these are just sad excuses. They're in these apps for over 15 minutes. It's not like they just walk by. They just say, buy Candy Crush, buy Just Dance, buy YouTube, buy Facebook, buy all of these. But the director claims that this is to get the emojis to know each other better. But even the term emojis is giving propaganda to literally emojis, text with emojis. It's just sad how much propaganda it has.
You know, kids' movies are supposed to have jokes. You know, those little gags that they just put in a movie, some dirty, some clean, that make the kids go hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo. In this movie, they tried so hard to put jokes in this movie.
In the nosebleeds.
I'm standing right here.
Hello, good simians. Those are some sharp attachés.
Yes, well, we have business to attend to.
What kind of business?
Monkey business.
And some jokes are really dark. Like in one scene, Smiler was like having a meeting with Gene, and she was having a floss, like dental floss or something. And the floss was shaped like a noose. A noose, I'm telling you. Yeah. And when she was holding it, Gene's head was right here. And the noose, it was so bad. I don't know why they put that in a kid's movie. But anyway, I need to talk about the jokes that were mostly better shown throughout the movie. And want to know what those jokes are? I'll give you a hint. Right here. Poop jokes! No one can get enough of them. They're the best kind of jokes ever made.
You might be making too much stink out of all this.
Soft poop.
Not too soft.
If they find a malfunction on the phone, we are all gonna be wiped!
She said wiped!
Aim higher, Steve.
Old management, I can't work like this! These lights! I'm melting in here! This is such a load of...
No, go ahead. Finish that sentence.
Are they over yet? Are they over yet? Oh my
Gosh! Talking about those jokes makes me... I need a glass of water. You're back.
The cringe factor in this movie is, like, unbelievably high. The Emoji Movie is super weird, and it tries desperately to be cool. The use of slang is very forced.
Blessed.
NBD, dude. Slay!
Ooh, shade.
And a failed attempt to make kids from our age group think that is a cool movie. Instead, it's just weird.
Sweetie, you're so handsome when you make that face.
Comfortable. Now, prepare yourselves. I'm going to tell you about the worst scene in the whole movie. The Emoji Pop Dance!
Emoji Pop!
Emoji Pop is so pointless and annoying, and the only true point of it was to try to involve music like previous films had done. This movie forced many things upon us that were supposed to make us like it, but they messed up terribly.
Ah, cliche moments in the Emoji Movie are abundant. I'll name a few. First of all, the entire plot line is cliche or unoriginal. We have Ralph, Jean, and then we have Penelope, Jailbreak, who are two misfits who are seeking the same thing, but have different goals on what to do with that thing. Sound familiar? Rudolph, Wreck-It Ralph. Okay, next one. The entire moral is just cliched and unoriginal, just copied from Rudolph. The moral is that if you're different, it's okay, unless if you can do something because you're different. The third cliche part is the last second cliche. Right at the last second, when Gene is about to be killed by the bots that Smiler sent out to destroy him, Jailbreak comes in the last second and kills the bots.
Delete the two malfunctions!
No!
It's so unoriginal.
Okay, I think by now, after watching the last few minutes of our video, you've definitely gotten the point this movie is a pile of trash. But there are some good things about it, surprisingly
what?
Enough. Yeah. First of all, the animation. The animation is actually really good. It gives you a good visual of what the world inside your phone would actually look like, and the characters look pretty good. Some of them look kind of stupid, but they look pretty great, and it's enjoyable to look at the animation. The storyboard is terrible, but the animation is great.
Also, the moral of the story is great and also important. You should always be yourself, no matter what other people think about you. Gene's purpose throughout the story is to discover this and accept himself for who he is.
I think the voice actors were pretty good for the movie. They did a pretty accurate job on what their emoji displays, but where the writing part was pretty lazy. If the writing was a little bit better, or they just thought with their brains, maybe the movie would have been a lot better.
Overall, I think we give this movie a 30% in Rotten Tomatoes, desiccating papayas. Because, this movie is really bad. And the only reason why we picked this movie for our project is because of the negative attention it got. We wanted to give out our own opinion on it. We wanted to see if that 9% they gave it was accurate. I mean, yeah, it was accurate, but I think a 9% is a little too harsh for this movie about how hard they tried on it. I mean, you should probably watch it for yourself. You either love it or hate it.
I don't recommend watching it.
Don't watch it.
That was a very, very stupid thing to say.
Okay, yes. Okay. This is...
Do not watch it.
Yeah, don't watch it.
Don't watch
it's,
it.
It's pretty bad.
How many shrimps do you have to eat before you make your skin turn pink? Eat too much and you'll get sick. Shrimps are pretty rich.